Hey there, Michael Church, Crawl Space Ninja and Basement Ninja. I've got some great radon testing tips for you all out there, and put together some slides to show you a little bit about the importance of addressing radon in your home. Now, this is a huge, huge problem and overlooked by a lot of homeowners. Don't go by those radon maps that you see. I would encourage each of you to test your home. Now, I'm gonna put some links to some test kits that you can get via Amazon that I recommend. The first one I would recommend you get is the First Alert test kit. This is a great test kit. I've got links down below, and I'll put links throughout the video so you can grab that one. Great, great test kit. So let's get started. So who is this video for? This video is for individuals that are concerned about their indoor air quality. Unfortunately, radon usually only comes up during a real estate transaction, but please, please, I encourage you, if you are concerned about your air quality, make sure you check for radon yourself. Even if the test was done during the real estate transaction, I would recommend you do your own test, because believe it or not, there are ways to cheat the radon test, and I'm sure there's a bunch of videos out there telling people how to do it, but and not that the tester would do that, but sometimes the homeowners might think about doing those sort of things, and they don't always get caught. So make sure that if you've just recently moved into a home, check the radon levels. And I'm not accusing everybody of being malicious, but let's face it, there are some people out there that don't want to spend money on radon systems, so they will try to do everything they can to bypass those tests. Did you know that radon is a Class A or Class 1 carcinogen? By the way, the EPA considers a Class A carcinogen as a pollutant with adequate human data indicating that the chemical causes cancer in people. So I've given a list of some of the Class A or Class 1 carcinogens that I'm sure most of you have heard of: radon, arsenic, asbestos, benzene, formaldehyde, hexavalent, chromium, tobacco smoke, and vinyl chloride. Now, quick trivia question down below. Tell me which of these was featured in the Julia Roberts movie, Aaron Brockovich, okay? So one of these that I've listed here was featured in that movie, and I'd like for you to tell me down below in the chat. Again, trying to bring a little bit of awareness. Did you know that according to the North Carolina Department of Human Health, every year there are over 21,000 deaths associated with elevated radon levels? It is the number two cause of lung cancer and the number one cause of lung cancer among non-smokers. It is responsible for more deaths than home fires and carbon monoxide. And you know, I just want to say, the carbon monoxide is great statistic as far as how low that number is, because I feel like we have done a good job, indoor air quality people, and of course, carbon monoxide testing devices are readily available all over. So they've done a really good job of getting that word out about carbon monoxide, and I'm hoping that they will start doing the same for radon. The state of Tennessee, for example, has Radon Awareness Month in January every year, and it really, really needs to be talked about more often. Speaking of the state of Tennessee, if you do happen to live in this state that I am currently in Tennessee, then you can apply for a free radon test kit. They have a Tennessee radon program, and I'll put a link to that over here, I believe. Whenever the video plays, you can click on that if you're in Tennessee. I'll also put a link in the description down below. So the average radon levels indoors is 1.3 picocuries per liter, and the average outdoor radon level is 0.4 picocuries per liter. Man, that's a tough word to say. By the way, they recommend that if you are above 2 picocuries per liter inside your home, you should consider getting radon mitigated. And if you are 4 or above, it should be done, no questions asked. Of course, it's your home, you do what you want, but during a real estate transaction, it would be dinged at 4 picocuries or above. And speaking of that, the national average for 4 picocuries or above is 7%. In other words, 1 in 15 homes has elevated radon levels. And again, this is according to the North Carolina Department of Health and Human Services. So that doesn't mean that only North Carolina has a radon problem. Across the country, there's pockets of radon everywhere you go. If you're not in a radon or a high radon map level area, I still would encourage you to check it just to be sure, because you could have high radon and your neighbor on both sides of you could not. So it's better to be safe than sorry when it comes to that. And of course, the source of all radon that we experience in our homes typically comes from the soil. There is a small amount of radon that can enter via the water system, but most of the time it's coming through soil pressurization into the house. That's why they recommend soil depressurization systems in order to address radon. So that's the number one way to get rid of radon in most cases. And of course, now let's talk about the test methods. There are continual test methods and then one-time test methods. And I'll list a few of these, but electret ion testing chambers, charcoal canisters, liquid scintillations, alpha tracks, and of course, continuous monitorings. All of these are used by radon testing professionals and some DIYers in order to test for radon. But what we're going to be talking about is the one-time use charcoal testing kits that you can get from Home Depot, Lowe's, different places like that. So let's get in some tips for how to make sure that the test goes accurate and is very accurate whenever you're doing it. Number one, you want to make sure you close all the windows and the doors a minimum of 12 hours before testing. If you are doing this during a real estate transaction, they recommend having two tests next to each other whenever you're doing the test kit. A lot of the times a test kit will look like this. It'll come packaged and sealed, and then you would open these up and you would place two of them next to each other during a real estate transaction, but you can place them throughout the room. One of the things I forgot to mention here is that if you have a basement with multiple HVAC systems or perhaps multiple slabs, perhaps maybe you built on or added on, and there's different footer systems inside of the basement, you want to make sure that you test each of those footer systems or each of those HVAC central units. Use the dehumidifiers and the heating and air units just as you normally would, but try to avoid any exhaust fans or ventilations, the bathroom fans, you know, your ERVs, your HRVs. Try to avoid those unless you're running them normally like you always would, of course. And then severe weather can change the building inside, the radon levels inside of a building. So if you got a big thunderstorm coming through or a lot of wind or something like that, you want to make sure that you try not to do the test during a major storm. Okay, now let's talk about choosing a test location. You always want to place the test at the lowest living level area, okay? So in a basement, for example, I used to tell people never ever place them in a crawl space, but believe it or not, I just did an interview with Ian in North Carolina, and he goes down, he uses his crawl space as his work area. So he's got his computer down there. It's tall enough for him to work in the area. He's got electrical and everything. He's even putting in a heating and air system down there to control the temperature. So if you're using your crawl space in that way, you would want to test in your crawl space or in your basement. So it doesn't, crawl spaces are not out just because they're crawl spaces, but if you're not using them in that way, then don't worry about testing in your crawl space. Always place it in the central part of the room. You want to place it within 2 to 7 feet of the floor. Place at least 3 feet from exterior windows and doors, and at least 1 foot from the walls, and ensure that there is at least 6 inches of space over the test. All right. I wouldn't recommend you put it in a bedroom where it could get knocked over or something like that, or in the middle of the TV room so you can't see the TV either. So these are some good tips for choosing a test location. Some things not to do when testing. Do not place the air sampler near the HVAC vents or anywhere where there's constant air moving. Do not allow the sample to get wet or in a room with high humidity. Believe it or not, high humidity can throw off the test, okay? So I would recommend, obviously, you want to keep it below 60%. I like 50% to be better, but that charcoal, if it's got a lot of moisture in it, and of course charcoal does absorb moisture, then that's less room for the radon to get into the charcoal. Do not place near closets, or I'm sorry, do not place inside closets, or as I mentioned, I've already covered the crawl spaces pretty well. Do not place in direct sunlight or near a heat source, because that can throw off the sample. And do not move the sample once you've started testing. So those are some do nots as far as the test kits. Now, to perform the test, you want to make sure that you expose the test between 48 and 96 hours. In fact, anything less than 2 days or anything more than 7 days will create an invalid test. You want to make sure you register the start date and time on the information form given with the test, and then register the stop date and time on the information form. Seal the sample in the mailer and send it to the lab ASAP. They need to get it within 10 days of the stop time, okay? That may mean that you have to perhaps FedEx it or overnight it, even though a lot of times the mailer is included. If your postal service doesn't deliver things in a timely manner, you may want to spend that extra money to send it overnight, because if they get it later than 10 days, they're going to consider it invalid, and then you're going to have to do it all over again. And then, of course, return multiple tests in their own mailers. You don't want to put like six tests in one mailer. Make sure that you seal them within their own mailers, and they'll come with all that inside the test kits. Last thing I want to recommend, if you haven't had a chance, I highly encourage you to watch this video I did with Bruce Sneed of Kansas State University. Expert in radon, great information. I highly recommend you check out this video with Bruce Sneed. And I am Michael Church with Crawl Space Ninja and Basement Ninja. We hope you make it a happy and blessed day, and we'll see you later.